abroad can be an interesting experience that encourages new world views and increases cultural curiosity. However, it may also invite a sense of feeling lost in the world. In fact, culture shock is a serious phenomenon. It often affects travelers and people living far from home for unexpected ways. Depending on personality, some people find it easier to adjust to another culture than others.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Benkadour Kautar et je suis actuellement en finance des entreprises et contrôle de gestion à l'IAE de Toulon. Suite à une demande d'une amie, j'ai décidé de vous faire cette vidéo pour vous parler un peu sur le choc culturel. En fait, ça fait quelques mois que je suis ici en France et sincèrement, j'ai rencontré plusieurs problèmes au niveau de culture. Et, par exemple, la bise, vu que je viens d'un pays musulman et surtout que je porte le voile, ce problème ne m'est jamais tombé dessus avant. Mais par contre, ici en France, s'il y a des gens qui ne me connaissent pas, une fois on est dans un groupe ou quelque chose du genre, ils viennent pour me faire la bise alors que pour moi, c'était pas normal et je suis pas du tout habituée. Mais petit à petit, il faut s'imposer, il faut leur dire, il faut leur montrer que je faisais pas la bise.
Deuxièmement, je vais parler de la nourriture. Au Maroc, je prends tout ce que je veux sans penser si c'est halal ou si ça contient pas de l'alcool. Alors que c'est pas le cas ici en France. Même du pain, il contient de l'alcool. Donc je me trouve obligée à chercher à chaque fois des boucheries halal et du pain halal. Et même de lire tous les ingrédients des articles en faisant mes courses.
Bonjour, moi c'est Ndi Hans, je suis gabonais, je suis étudiant au Maroc depuis 2016. Ce que j'aime au Maroc, c'est précisément sa culture, parce qu'elle est centrée sur la famille, sur les bonnes mœurs, sur la religion, sur la valeur de la vie, l'importance de tout ce qui est sacré. Ce que j'apprécie le plus dans ce pays, c'est cette biodiversité entre ancien, modernisme. Et franchement, c'est un environnement où je me sens bien. Franchement, ouais.
Hola, buenas tardes a todos. Soy El Amri, tengo 19 años, soy estudiante de medicina en España desde 3 meses. España es un país maravilloso, con mucha vida, la gente es amable y el clima es templado como en Marruecos. El video les cuenta sobre las diferencias y choques culturales entre Marruecos y la vida en España. Ante todo, el choque cultural no es un término médico ni una enfermedad, simplemente es un sentimiento de confusión y nerviosismo que una persona puede tener después de dejar una cultura. Cuando te mudas a un país o a un lugar a otro, debes enfrentar muchas cambios. Por ejemplo, los domingos está todo cerrado. Olvídate, no podrás comprar nada. Aquí la gente bebe mucha cerveza, tienen cerveza en su casa, en el trabajo, en la universidad. Hay patatas con sabor de jamón, a jamón con vino, pan con vino, así que debes tener mucho cuidado.
Bonsoir, je m'appelle Omar Lamil, j'ai 23 ans. Je suis en France depuis 2017-2018, ça fait même pas 2 ans. Actuellement, je suis en M2, management de PME-PMI à Boulogne-sur-Mer, sur le Nord-Pas-de-Calais. Et concernant mon intégration, personnellement, je trouve que l'intégration, surtout en France, des Marocains, ça demande pas beaucoup d'efforts. Faut juste au départ bouger un peu et faire des activités pour créer des liens. Et des connaissances et un entourage qui va s'élargir au fur et à mesure. Et il faut aussi quand même avoir l'esprit un peu ouvert et accepter la différence culturelle, parce que bien évidemment on ne pense pas de la même façon que les Français, on n'a pas eu la même éducation. Mais il faut non plus abandonner sa culture, parce que c'est son identité. Et pour moi personnellement, j'ai pas trouvé de difficulté pour m'intégrer, je suis bien ici, je me sens chez moi. Merci.
Ich heiße Ayub, ich bin 21 Jahre alt, ich komme aus Marokko und lebe hier in Deutschland. Ich bin fast 3 Jahre hier in Deutschland, ich studiere, ich bin im 4. Semester, ich studiere Fotografie und Mediendesign in der Hochschule Bochum. Am Anfang hatte ich auch Schwierigkeiten, die Kultur anzunehmen. Hier die Arbeit ist das A und O, man muss so richtig, also wie eine Maschine, hart und vernünftig arbeiten. Also auch wegen des Wetters, die Leute, die zeigen also meist nicht ihre emotionale Seite. Auch hier in Deutschland ist gibt's gar keine Freizeit. Also man muss immer was machen, also jeden Tag. Zum Beispiel ich studiere und arbeite, also fast jeden Tag. Dann, ja, wie gesagt, man kann also gar keine Freizeit finden.
Vas-y. Bonjour, je suis Makele Fridjamsi. Je viens du Gabon, étudiant à Sup Management. Le Maroc, je trouve que c'est un pays très ouvert, les gens sont accueillants. Je vis à Fès et c'est une ville dans laquelle je me sens bien, je m'intègre bien facilement. Merci.
The degree of similarity between the host and the home cultures of immigrants can predict the acculturation stress experienced by immigrants. For example, Sudanese immigrants in Australia exhibit significantly larger psychological and cultural distance as compared to those from New Zealand.
Now we move to cause. The first cause, cultural shock, is produced by the loss of familiar symbols and signs that we use in order to relate socially, including norms, implicit or explicit communication signs. In our home country, we know perfectly how to handle our daily situations and we do so automatically. On the contrary, when we face new culture and environment, our usual ways of acting and communicating don't produce the same results, and our activities will not be neither enjoyable nor efficient until we learn the new symbols and signs that are specific to our new context. The second cause, cognitive fatigue, which is the feeling of exhaustion produced by the effort needed to comprehend the function of things in our new context and to learn and understand the local language. We could see these causes as the result of the first cause. The third cause and the last, role shock, which is the ambiguity the individual feels with respect to his new social position. In other words, when additionally to facing a new culture and context, we also need to learn how to be someone different to whom we were before.
When an individual encounters new culture and experiences culture shock, the change and the infamiliarity with the new culture affect their psychological adjustments in that new cultural surrounding. This is psychological. The psychological mystification and emotional discomfort usually creates stress. The negative impact of culture shock in individual psychology often includes a large and diverse set of symptoms such as anxiety and depression. when depression and anxiety and feeling of helplessness accumulate, individuals who are affected by these symptoms find it very difficult to pay attention to the learning of new cultures. As a result, it decreases their motivation of adapting new environment. However, if an individual fails to fight against the symptoms of culture shock, they are more likely to become hostile to host nationals, which may lead to handicap of interpersonal relationship.
Ask questions. It's okay to ask others to help you or explain things to you. Share your culture. Be proud of your heritage. Many people would like to take advantage of your knowledge, just as you can enjoy theirs. Talk to your family. You may be surprised to learn that they share a lot of your feelings. You could solve your difficulties together. Change only a few things at once. It's important to keep many family rituals. Find hobbies. It may be helpful to join people who have similar interests to you. Get help. Talk to others who have moved to Canada. Talk to others who have moved to Canada to share ideas about what's helpful. Talk to people you care about, such as friends, teachers, counselors, or others in your community. Give yourself time. Changes take time. Do not try to change too fast or change too many things at the same time. What to do about all this? Learn the language. Not understanding what people say is almost as annoying as not knowing how to be understood.
The term culture shock is used to denote the anxiety that results from losing all our familiar sense and symbols. Anxiety and stress occur when people encounter difficulties adjusting to the new culture, not being able to communicate with other people in the society or struggling with learning the new language. People will usually get over the stress and anxiety when they successfully go through the stages of culture shock. It is not justifiable to attribute cultural characteristics to genetic inheritance. On the other hand, culture itself is a kind of adaptation which gives humans the ability to survive in a wide range of environments. Thus, once learned, it becomes a way of life as an adapted culture for that individual. In this video, we try to describe the culture shock. We have illustrated this case by asking our friends who left their countries to study abroad, and they give us what they have been through over there. To conclude, don't forget that there are so many immigrants that come from foreign places to our country for many reasons: job, life, family, etc. So for that, we should take on consideration their beliefs, religions, language, in one word, their culture. We must eliminate discrimination, welcome, protect them, and make them feel one of ours. The term culture shock is used to denote the anxiety that results from losing all our familiar sense and symbols. Anxiety and stress occur when people encounter difficulties adjusting to the new culture, not being able to communicate with other people in the society or struggling with learning the new language. People will usually get over the stress and anxiety when they successfully go through the stages of culture shock. It is not justifiable to attribute cultural characteristics to genetic inheritance. On the other hand, culture itself is a kind of adaptation which gives humans the ability to survive in a wide range of environments. Thus, once learned, it becomes a way of life as an adapted culture for that individual. To conclude, don't forget that there are so many immigrants that come from foreign places to our country for many reasons: job, life, family, etc. In this video, we try to describe the culture shock. We have illustrated this case by asking our friends who left their countries to study abroad, and they give us what they have been through over there. So for that, we should take on consideration their beliefs, religions, language, in one word, their culture. We must eliminate discrimination, welcome, protect them, and make them feel one of ours.
Culture shock works.
Culture shock